With every new Bond film comes new Bond gadgets. Skyfall saw the return of James Bond sporting the Xperia T by Sony. Outside of Europe, it's known as the Xperia TX, and while the internals are identical, there are slight variations to the externals, but effectively, the T and the TX are one and the same. Let's rip open the box and take a first look, but let me know below what you want to see the new Bond phone perform. In the box, we have the TX unit front and center. First impressions are really good for the TX. Sleek back front, no physical buttons, fairly streamlined body, slight curvature to complement its 8.6mm thinness, and a nice soft touch backing. Doesn't scream high tech though, but perhaps when the phone is on it will. Putting it aside, you'll find a set of Sony branded in-ear headphones for your music needs given the appeal of Sony's Walkman app. Then there is the obvious inclusions of the AC power adapter, micro USB cable as standard in Android devices, and the product information and warranty. The Xperia TX comes boasting a 4.55 inch display with 720p resolution, which works out to around 323 ppi pixel density, on par with the top competitors of 2012. This and the placement of the unlock button at the top left hand side of the device are the main differences of note between the Xperia T and the TX. Both sport an easily removable rear panel, with the TX housing a 1750 mAh battery. Sony only packed a mere 1.5 GHz dual-core Qualcomm CPU, Adreno 225 GPU to boost graphics performance, and 1 gig of RAM in both models. Very un-Bond-like, but maybe it's how you optimize the specs at hand that makes it Bond-worthy. However, the 13-megapixel espionage-driven main camera gives it presence with up to 16 times digital zoom and full HD video, and the 1.3-megapixel front-facing camera to enable brilliant video chat. Onboard memory is set at 16 gig and complemented by a microSD card slot up to another 32 gig. NFC is included, but LTE antennas are not. However, HSDPA Plus channels should give reasonable downloads. The display is certainly crisp and fantastically bright thanks to the mobile Bravia engine, but Sony's overlay I have always found to be a little sterile and underpowered out of the box. But these are early days yet. Let's hear your suggestions for what you want to see Bond's phone of choice do, and work out whether Sony should be MI6's chosen manufacturer, or whether sluggish performance will see Bond's untimely end. Remember to like and subscribe. This has been Kurt from KABOOtech. Hang around for more.